Why is it that people love to fly around the world at relatively low prices, but why is it that generally the public doesn't seem to like airlines?
Well, a couple things. You're right. Prices, since so next year will be the 40th anniversary of deregulation, and so many new things have been offered, so many products. And to your point on pricing, I think the number is 40-45% on an inflation-adjusted basis. Prices are actually lower. Schedules are increased. We have much farther reach. But the customer has evolved as well. And again, as I said, we have 150 million of you wonderful people every year, and you all have opinions on various aspects. And, you know, not everyone dislikes things, but people that fly very infrequently. So, for instance, luggage and a fee around luggage. That if you haven't flown in a few years and now you have to pay it, you get angry. And so things have evolved. Good thing is the airline industry is generally profitable, where you used to hear about us in bankruptcy every other day.
Right.
And so we have to balance that history of providing everything you want all the time at a low price to still having a relatively low economic price, but also adding all the product and value and schedule and efficiency that we've been able to do.
Now, in the old days, as you pointed out, old days 30 years ago or so, a lot of airlines were going out of business.
I've read about the old days. I don't know.
Braniff, TWA, Trump Shuttle, they're not around anymore. I don't know what happened.
Not going there.
Okay. So I don't know. Did you ever fly on the Trump Shuttle? I don't know. But so why are there so many airlines that went out of business? But today, the airlines seem to be profitable. Is that because the algorithms have worked so you know how to actually have not too many empty seats?
Well, consolidation has helped. I mentioned my railroad experience, and I think if you look at their history, I think the airline has closely followed the same evolution of less folks vying for the same amount of customers. Certainly as part of it, I think some discipline around how we invest, how much product we offer, how we price, and how, more importantly, how we are efficient. But underlying it all, I can never forget the fact that all this product is supported by the human beings that run the airline every single day.
What's the best way to get the lowest price? Do people go online and book it themselves? Do they go through a travel agent?
Probably in broad aspects, the further out you book, the better options that you have. But people use an interesting array of folks. So travel agents are still big customers of ours, and they're still part of it. Our direct channels for us, united.com, is a growing channel.
So is it possible that somebody could be sitting next to somebody else on an airline, he or she paid a lower price, and the person sitting right next to him or her?
Nobody talks about that, but yeah, that's been an issue forever. I mean, you've got a corporate customer on a corporate discount, you're someone that booked far ahead. So usually, I mean, I don't know about you in the room, I don't usually ask who's sitting next to me, hey, by the way, how much did you pay for that ticket?
Well,
but it is an issue, but it's not a significant one.